Hey, how's it going, guys? Psych Guys back here again. Thank you guys so much for watching, tuning in, watching. This video's done already now. I apologize also, by the way. I'm really tired right now. I actually got back from the club about 2 hours ago. It's kind of like residency, you know, when you're staying up all night, you're working with patients. Next thing you know, it's like 5:30 in the morning. It's pointless to sleep, right? Because next thing you know, you're gonna have to go ahead and wake up 2 hours to go and present to the attending, residence report, that kind of thing. So yeah, same concept. So I'm basically hopped up on coffee, you know, just basically coughing it up and so on. So let's get to this video. Actually, no, before I get this video, I gotta tell you about my night last night. Well, let's talk about my night. It was wild. It was weird. Dude, I saw this hot blonde last night. I want to get her digits. And so let's play the clip. We have a clip about that. Hey, what's going on? Hey, listen, I just want to tell you that I saw, okay, it's kind of weird that you're singing, but anyway, no, I just want to say that, listen, I saw you from across the room, you're very mesmerizing. I mean, alas, your presence is blinding. Okay, this is, why are you in a box, by the way, and what is this? And if you thought that was weird, her friend got all gorilla later on the night, You say that I waste my time, but I can't get you off my... Alright, so that was my night last night, and yeah, for those of you who cared, which is probably... Yes. Right there, yeah. All right, James Bond, right? No, okay. So let's get to this video right here. This is a very quick one. Honestly, truth be told, I am right now in the process of moving. So I gotta make this video really quick. Bing, bang, bang, bing, boom, boom.
Bing, bing, bong, bong, bing, bing, bing.
And we're gonna do this really quick. I'm gonna try to talk a little faster and so on. Like normally talk, so I'm gonna talk a little faster. This video about Johnny Depp. This is about Johnny Depp Amber Heard case. Really, there's not much to analyze here. I'm gonna go ahead and go back to my notes later and kind of try to fine pick it, tooth comb thing, whatever. Actually, I'm going to jump into my notes here, and yeah, I just reviewed them, and as expected, there's nothing really much to talk about here. And for full disclosure, as always, just in my past vids, anything that involves a child or a victim of some sorts, or like, a sensitive topic here, such as, you know, the overlying topic here of domestic V/spousal A, I'm purposely demonetizing this video because Psych Guy will never sell out. Congratulations, you're in the most underground, genuine from the heart type channel because there are no conscious underlying monetary motivations here. I mean, I know I can't speak the same about the other vids on this topic, but my goodness, the sycophantic idealization of an individual, that being Johnny Depp, is just unnecessarily overwhelming and uncalled for, in my humble opinion. I mean, sure, it's obvious the majority of vids that are on Team Depp is just for the clicks, just for the views, the boosting of sub numbers, the boosting of potential revenue. I mean, but this is all just ridiculous. I mean, I like him, I don't mind him as an actor, but what I cannot stand in general, and this doesn't specifically apply to him, but to society in general, but this overall gravitation, an excessive admiration towards superficial celebritization, I don't think that's even a word, but I'm just gonna roll with it because I wanna quickly get this video out. But you know, treating millionaire celebrities as if they are like demigods, in lieu of the true heroes, such as the moms and dads or the caretakers across the globe, for example, who are directly helping and improving someone's life. Look, like I said, you know, I like Johnny Depp. I think he's a wonderful actor, but there is no need to fanboy or fangirl it up, you know, for anyone, because we all probably, you know, have more pressing familial issues to deal with in our, you know, present real day lives, right? I mean, dude, even if the person, okay, excluding my personal family or friends, but even if it was like, say, the person who I look up to the most, like my absolute role model, who was like the coolest person in the history of everything, no cap, but dude, even if it were Captain Caveman instead of Johnny Depp, I will still be holding on to the same position.
I miss you so much, but I promise one day I'll see you again, Captain Caveman.
But I get it. Depp's got that edge to him that we all can relate to. He's the guy that the males want to be, that the females want to be with. Well, most females and some males. But yeah, I kid you not, regarding Johnny Depp, I popped into a YouTube channel on Friday that was streaming a live look into the courthouse, and I swear there were more comments about how cool Johnny Depp looked, his hair, the earrings, how, you know, people stated they knew him or want to meet him. You know, just waste of time comments that had nothing to do with anything about the case. Oh, and that's the other thing. A lot of people are focused. And there's all these vids that are analyzing his body movements and his dress and what he wore, what she wore, how he looked, how she looked, how he spoke. Look, at the end of the day, none of this is going to matter. Axl Rose, many years ago, proved this very point. Hate him or love him, but my man walked into the courthouse. Bro didn't even bother cutting his hair. He didn't bother shaving. On top of that, my man was rocking a teal suit that he probably bought from the Steve Harvey collection. Homeboy acting like he was going to the church of the Easter egg saints or something. Welcome to the Jesus! There's no fun in games.
Actually, were you surprised that Steve found the lawsuit?
Within a month or two of the time that Guns N' Roses formed, were you aware of any of its members doing drugs?
Yes.
And he still fared well with the verdict. So, really no need to analyze all the little nitpicky looks and gestures like all these other channels slash vids are doing, but I get it. I mean, that's what they're doing. At the end of the day, it's all about getting the clout, basic classic manipulation of the masses. Hey, just spoon-feeding what the public wants to hear. The media does this all the time. But in regards to this case, what's going to probably happen is that from the jury standpoint, more than likely, if they were a competent jury, they probably would realize and say, once deliberations hit, you know, behind closed doors, well, he's an actor, she's an actor, maybe he was acting on the stand, maybe she was acting on the stand. I don't know. We don't know what to believe. So I think what's going to happen is going to be like a cancellation effect. I think his being on the stand and giving testimony will cancel and negate, you know, her being on the stand and, you know, giving testimony. You know, i.e. like a queen is sacrificed for a queen in chess, you know, boom, boom. So really at the end of the day, I think the jury is going to focus on what is this case really about. And I think they're going to realize it is a case where Depp is suing her for defamation after an op-ed that she posted in the Washington Post a few years back. I actually read the op-ed she put out, and nowhere near did it mention his name at all. So I am not sure where others are seeing a direct correlation, because I surely am not. And for those reasons, I think he's probably going to lose his case, which is going to be a good thing for him. More on that later before I finish up a quick other points here. I actually liked her op-ed. Again, I'm not on anyone's side. I don't really care about Amber Heard. I don't really care about Johnny Depp. Actually, maybe, like I said before, I can't remember. I'm just trying to quickly get through this. So if I repeat myself, I apologize. But out of the two, I do like Johnny a little better. Maybe it's because I've seen more of his movies than hers and grew up on his stuff, you know, rather than, you know, her. I don't know. What I do know is Amber's op-ed was greatly written, whether she actually wrote it or not. I encourage anyone who didn't read it to do so. I thought her pointing out about the point about institutional misogynism, I thought she was spot on there. And, you know, the importance, you know, highlighting the importance of such vital acts, such as the violence against women, I think is really crucial in order for the advancement of our civilization. Not to mention the other little details about the acknowledgement about the rampant sexabuse cases on college campuses. So yeah, again, though I don't care too much about Amber, big props for her to write this. I mean, even if she were trying to do this for attention to herself, still, I gotta appreciate the fact that someone is actually talking about this. And maybe I'm a little biased being that I'm in the psych field, but heck, I don't care. It doesn't matter. I mean, the more the merrier, the more, you know, talking about this, you know, knowledgeable about this, you know, addressing this, right? The merrier. You know, what I would have liked better, preferred, or what I wanted to, you know, see Johnny Depp have done was to counter, you know, make a counter to that op-ed and basically, you know, highlight his agreeance to what she stated about the social inequalities and gender unfairness. And then, you know, maybe also on top of that, you know, hinting at the fact that he has always been a, you know, very supportive partner, you know, highlighting how wonderful of a partner he was, his ex-partner for 14 years, Vanessa Paradis, I believe that's how you pronounce her last name. I know she's French, Francais, you know, and how they raised two beautiful children together. That, I think, would have been the best thing, or that was what I would have done if I were him. But instead, you know, we find him here suing Amber Heard for defamation, which is fine. I mean, it is what it is. So I think the best case scenario would be for Johnny to take the L. Why do I say that? Okay, so allow me to explain. Johnny's real enemy in all of this is systemic ageism. In fact, the real enemy in all our lives is aging. Aging leads to the finality of life, right? It eventually ends up in the cessation of life, i.e. death. So with systemic ageism, basically what I'm referring to is that, okay, the best way to explain this is that Johnny Depp is an entertainer. I like to think in threes and groups of threes, and in the entertainment field, whether you're a singer, an actor slash actress, whatever it is, the three decades that are the peak decades are the 20s, 30s, and 40s. In my field, it's more so the 40s, 50s, 60s, because people would rather, you know, prefer to see experienced docs, which I totally get. But in regards to Johnny's case, you know, movie producers cast out and have an abundance of more roles for adults between, you know, their 20s to 40s, maybe 50s. And as you get older in Hollywood, let alone anywhere in the entertainment business, it's rare for someone to still be desired and on top of their game past their 50s. You know, there's always gonna be few exceptions anywhere you go. Kylie Minogue is one of the rare exceptions that I can pull out of the top of my head because my baby never ages, and I know I may get some heat here, but disco is better than fever. There, I said it. I believe she was 50 when Disco came out versus I believe she was 30-ish when Fever came. But you get my point. But with Depp, sure, one can argue that he may be still at the top of his game. But let's be real here. Johnny was going to anyways be sort of phased out. Hollywood and the public, they're not going to want to continue to see Johnny in those roles that put him, you know, to the top. The only reason why Pirates of the Caribbean continued on past the third one was not because of Johnny Depp, but it was more because of China. How do I know? Because I used to own Disney stock. Not anymore. I swung it for profit. But I'm not sure if it was during an annual shareholder meeting or during an earnings call. This was many, many years ago. But the CEO clearly mentioned that there is a large financial incentive, high revenue to continue in the Pirates franchise because of China. And though I think Depp did a wonderful job, I think China would have always continued seeing these movies, whether he was in it or not, being that China is a landlocked country for the most part, and the unconscious fantasy of escapism, you know, across open waters and the dangers that may lie awake. Yeah, I think China wouldn't really care who was in that movie, even if it were Scooby-Doo. So the bottom line is that this inherent, unintentional, systemic ageism would have weeded him out naturally out of the spotlight. And if this never happened, you know, like what he's going through right now, you know, no one would be really focused or talking about him right now, right? And there are countless of A-grade actors to bring up this point. Like, look at Charlie Sheen. Okay, wait, maybe not a good example here. Okay, another terrible example. We're gonna leave that one alone. Russell Crowe. He's a perfect example, and they're both 58. When's the last time you heard of him or anybody talking about him? Everyone's favorite movie of his, or what they're going to remember him, is of 20 years ago, right? When he did Gladiator, like 20 years, 20 plus years ago, right? Just like with Johnny Depp, you know, with the Pirates of the Caribbean, that, you know, that's his staple. That's his baby. That's his, you know, that's right, you know, his, but yeah, that's him. That's boom, you know, Pirates, Johnny. there's not going to be another role in the future that he's going to do that will overtake it. He's going to be remembered forever, mainly for the Pirates franchise. So in a way, this court case is really a blessing. The bottom line is 90 to 95% of folks are probably with him, to that of Amber's 5 to 10%, just based on his likability factor, to what I alluded earlier about how everyone wants to either be with him or be him. You know, he's got that it factor. And what better thing to happen, at least in my opinion, if he takes the L, he loses the case. And then the general public will be outraged even more, and he could, if he wanted to, run with it. You know, just because the high emotional valence and investing all this energy into this case, you know, with all these people like riled up and so on. So, yeah, I mean, this right here is definitely better. We could play about better for him instead of going back, you know, winning the case and then having to go back to the few acting gigs later to choose from. You know, that was naturally anyways going to happen because he's almost 60 now, right? He could instead pick and choose and pretty much name his price in terms of speaking engagements and rolling with, for example, men's victims advocacy groups or unjust spousal ABUS, you know, rights groups, right? This to me is a highly controversial and polarizing topic. People's emotions seem to be highly invested into this, and I can see folks follow suit and invest a lot of money to hear him speak, especially after the further perception of victimization has occurred, you know, having lost for a second time in court, the first time being in England, right? You know, a few years ago, I forgot to mention that he lost a case in England, which I don't think has really much relevance here in America. But anyways, people would pay, the bottom line is that people would pay a lot of money. I mean, if someone like a no-talent Paris Hilton can pull in $1 million to DJ, true story, okay? I believe Johnny can do the same. And maybe if it's not that high, but still it can add up, and probably my guess is he would collectively get more of a financial gain over time, the remainder of his life, you know, on top of producing and starring in his own movies, i.e. if he wants to make his own. Heck, he can hire himself as a lead actor. Instead of relying on corporate Hollywood elites to anyways not even pick up the phone, irregardless of this controversy, because they anyways were going to probably replace him with someone younger. Oh, and another thing also is, don't get wrapped up in the dollar amount Johnny is seeking. Though it's $50 million, and let's just pretend he wins, which, as I stated earlier in the video, I would be shocked if he does. Now, a third will more than likely go to his lawyers, and the remainder he probably won't see, realistically speaking, till maybe his mid-60s, I'm guessing, because I'm pretty sure Amber is going to appeal, and these appeals can sometimes take many, many years. Plus, he'll be losing out on additional revenue that he could have made while he was waiting, sitting on the sidelines, right? You know, the more I think of it, I wouldn't be surprised if there are going to be now some motion picture companies out there that may come out to try to hire him for roles, you know, win or lose, whatever the case may be, of which they weren't even interested or thinking of, you know, to begin with. But now with all this controversy and, you know, his name being on the spotlight and so on, hey, look, I mean, controversy sells, right? And he's definitely got the public really behind him. So that's my quick analysis on this case. Look, here's the bottom line. Johnny's no angel. Amber's no angel. They both are guilty and both were participants in this toxic relationship. Sure, more than likely, one of them is lying more than the other, but we will never know. I won't know. You won't know. The judge and the jury won't know. Only two people truly know. And I am not faulting Johnny for not leaving sooner than he should have, despite his having plenty more resources than the common victim of DV, you know, spousal A. Seems like there was probable projective identification that I think prevented him from leaving sooner than he should have. But the bottom line is, the real victim of all of this is not Johnny, or it's not Amber. The marginalization of DV is the true victim. Unfortunately, the speaking against DV and how to help out victims, you know, and advice and other such, you know, helpful information is unfortunately being unintentionally overshadowed by the egos of two Hollywood celebs in this he said, she said court case. Well, all right, that's a wrap. If you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Plenty more SPG to come later this year when I'm not quite sure. Got a lot of stuff going on in my life. Like I said, that's why I wanted to crank this video out today. So glad I did. I hope you guys enjoyed it. But yeah, it was a lot of fun making. And we will be back. Oh, the channel will be changing also. You don't know what I'm talking about. Trust me. It's going to be awesome. I can't wait. But yeah, you guys take care. I love each and every one of you. I really, really, truly do. And most importantly, to that hot blonde. Like a